No one turn away. For details, call 415-821-6545 or visit answersf.org. On Wednesday, January 7th at 7:30 p.m., Hiroshima survivor Takashi Tanemori, founder of Silkworm Peace Institute, will share the secret of self-healing through forgiveness. This free event is located at 941 The Alameda in Berkeley. Optional pasta dinner, $6 for adults, children free. For details, call 510-526-3805. The community calendar is produced by members of the First Voice Apprenticeship Program. Send your listing at least 3 weeks in advance to KPFA Box 51, 1929 Martin Luther King Jr. Way in Berkeley, California, 94704. Fax them to 510-848-3812 or email us at calendar@kpfa.org. Attention to the community calendar. Tell us if your event is wheelchair accessible. To hear this calendar again, call 510-848-6767 extension 621. This calendar is also online at kpfa.org.
And the time is 7:01 on January 1st. 2009. How come he's not? Happy New Year's. Can you hear yourself, Adriel?
I can't hear myself.
I don't think you're on. Can you? Are you
I
on?
Can hear you guys.
Yes. All right. You're listening to KPFA Berkeley 94.1 FM and 89.3 KPFB Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF Fresno, and online at kpfa.org. KPFA.org. Stay tuned for Apex Express, the only Asian American Pacific Islander show worth listening to.
Apex Express, Asian Pacific Expression.
Community and cultural coverage.
Music and calendar.
New visions and voices.
Coming to you with an Asian Pacific Islander point of view.
It's time to get on board the Apex Express.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Man, I'm not used to this new intro music. Adriel, what happened when I moved to LA? Oh, let me lower this. Hello, 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 hello. Get up to the mic, please.
Dude.
Oh, there you are. There you are.
My headphones broke.
Your headphones broke?
And,
how did they break?
And the mic wasn't working.
Man, what, it's 2009. Things should be new over here, KPFA. You know? What's up, right. Y'all? My name is DJ Patrick.
My name is Adriel Lewis.
And we have a special guest.
This is Jason Miani.
Yes, yes. This is the first Apex Express of the year, 2009, January 1st. I am back in the Bay specifically for this show. This is not a pre-recording. This is live. Right, Adriel?
That's right. Now that gas is down to like $1.75, Patrick can now cross the state song once again.
Yes. So, I mean, it's the first. There's nobody in the building in KPFA. It's just me, Adriel, and Jason, and maybe somebody lurking in the shadows. But since it's a new year, we decided just to make it a family affair, like Sly Stallone. And,
great.
Stallone. I mean, Sly Stone. And, you know, we invited, we invited the Bay Area API community to come out and bless us with their words. So Jason came out.
I'm still laughing that you called Sly Stone's
Sly Stallone.
Yeah, half two very different people.
Half the KPFA audience is shaking their head and calling in and canceling their subscriptions. I'm sorry that it cost y'all some donation money. Anyways,
one's Rocky, the other one's Stony.
This is Apex Express, the only APIA public affairs culture radio show in the Bay Area.
That's right.
That's broadcast on the FM dial. API, if y'all don't know, I say this every time, but API stands for
Asian
Pacific
Islander.
Yes, yes.
We intentionally left Jason.
This is 2009, and y'all should know that by now. But if you don't know that, call in. We can explain some more. Read some Takaki texts for you. Blah, 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 blah.
What did you just say?
Takaki, not I don't think I broke any rules there. But let's just start with a song, man. So basically, we're going to have a bunch of folks. We're going to talk about 2008, what we look forward in 2009. We're going to go over actually some dope API Asian American music that came out. Not just Asian American, but API period music that came out in 2008. Do a little review. Oh, man. I am rusty. Do a little year in review.
This is full Patrick's getting ready for Chinese New Year.
But we're going to start off with a little band from Japan, right?
No, Fatty.
What?
From Brazil.
Really?
But, yes, but the lead is Japanese-Brazilian. This is CSS. Music is my hot, hot sex.
CSS, the song is called?
The song is called Music is My Hot, Hot Sex. The lead vocalist, her name is Love Fox. Straight out of Brazil.
Love Fox?
Love Fox.
Like the Fox.
Love.
Oh, Love Fox.
Love
oh, wow.
Fox with a triple X.
You know, what better way to start off 2009 with some love?
Fox.
Fox.
Fox. What's up, we got? This is DJ Fatrick. This is Apex Express. You're yes, on KPFA. Yes.
Fatty's so sweet. He got me some new headphones because my... So just so you know how messed up my headphones were, like, one ear wasn't working, the other ear wouldn't stay on the headphone. And so I had to hold it up like one of those old school...
You know what that means?
Phones.
That means... To the listening public out there, whether you're at 94.1 KPFA Berkeley, you're in Fresno, or you're online on KPFA.org, we need money to fix these headphones.
Yeah, you know, like you think we're a big radio station, like the one in Springfield, in The Simpsons with the big antenna that blasts out to everybody else.
Huge letters say KPFA. No,
no,
there's no money for huge letters.
You know, we're actually sitting on crates right now.
Please support community. Radio, progressive, community, radio. Go online, kpfa.org. There's the fun drives, but there's also you can always donate anytime you want on the website. We got a special guest, Mr. Jason Bayani in the house.
What's up? Woot.
How y'all proletariat doing? Bronze fame.
For folks who don't know, tell real quick a little bio about yourself. Who are you? Who's proletariat bronze?
I just been, you know, lurking around here doing spoken word, poetry slam, all that stuff. You can catch me most nights over at the Berkeley Poetry Slam every Wednesday at Starry Plow. Usually over there. I'm not performing, I'm hanging out. But I haven't been performing as much because I'm going to school right now. Because school is hard.
What are you doing in school?
I'm getting my MFA in creative writing.
Oh, nice.
And yeah, so it's pretty cool. But I still got to work full time while I'm doing it. So, yeah, I'm tired all the time.
How was your 2008? What was the ups and downs of 2008 for you?
Geez, a lot of good stuff happened this year. I had a really cool year. You know, I had some downs, but like, one of the coolest things was my brother was on America's Best Dance Crew this summer. You know,
he must roll for that.
Supreme Soul.
He must be Filipino.
Yes. But it was, that was really cool. You know, we even got to go over there and check out. Yeah, I got to go to the show where his group got eliminated.
Oh.
That's bummer.
Moment of silence.
It's probably down to NPR voice.
Anyway, we're back in 2009. It is January 1st of 2009. Did you know that when you add all those numbers together, you get 13?
That's called breaking stereotypes because we don't do math well.
The zeros threw me off.
There you go. That's breaking stereotypes. I'm Chinese. Asia's Chinese. And we don't do math very well. So,
Hey, you speak for yourself, son.
One stereotype broken. Jason, I want to go off. I actually want to ask you more about this Supreme Soul, America's Best Dance Crew. I feel like that show came out in 2008, right? It just got premiered.
Yeah. The first one was beginning of the year. And then, like, then they did the second season in the summer.
What do you think? I mean, I feel like, how does this show, it featured a lot of hip-hop dancers, which actually, there's a lot of Filipino-Americans involved. Yeah. In hip-hop dance.
Yeah, it is a lot. I mean, it was a huge... I mean, throughout, like, for both of the seasons, especially the second season, I mean, it's like, you know, you had Supreme Soul, you had So Real Crew, and, like, you know, practically every, like, you know, Super Crew, two guys, you know, but you got Asian folks in it, and then you had, like, all the crews practically had at least one, like, Asian American
person.
Yeah,
the one from, was it Texas? No, where was it? Maybe it was Atlanta, right? It had that one API dude who's actually deaf.
Yeah, no, they were from Detroit.
Yeah, that's
even,
right.
Even those those dudes from Illinois with the really kind of with the popped up collars and the greasy, like they looked real greasy. Right. Like they had an Asian American dude on them.
I mean, how do you feel about that? I mean, do you think this is accurate? Do you think finally Asian Americans are seeing this is kind of a step up in terms of like a scene in three-dimensional manners as fully human beings?
Three-dimensional. Have you seen them when they do their suicides and their head spins?
So is this 2008 a critical year in us coming up in popular media?
I don't know. You know, I mean that's. I mean, I'd like to say yeah, and like to believe so. You know, But
have Filipinos become the model minority of hip-hop dance?
What does that even mean?
Filipinos have been in, you know, Asian American spirit involved in, like, this kind of dancing, you know, I mean, for a long time. I remember back, like, you know, when I was in high school and stuff, and I was watching, like, the... back when they were doing the World War III, World War III, and there was always these like dance battles and stuff happening in San Jose all the time. And
but now it's on MTV, which is crazy, you know? And like the first winning group, the Jabberwockies, is primarily Filipino American.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
You know, I felt like, I mean, Adrian Lewis can attest to this. He would walk through the airport with illiteracy, you know, they all got the best clothes on, all that stuff, and people would think they were the Jabberwockies, right?
You have the best clothes on.
You guys have like all that new fitted gear stuff that I can't afford to get, or I don't have any sponsors.
And then none of us are Filipinos except for Ruby, and then Jabberwockies didn't have any girls in it.
Well, didn't you get a mistake in the airport?
Yeah, no, I got mistaken several times for being part of America's Best Dancer.
In a positive way, right?
I mean, I guess.
I don't know.
They were like, hey, you're Asian and you're wearing a fedora hat, therefore... Well, yeah, they pretty much... I don't know. It was neutral, I would say.
Me growing up, I feel like the only... In my generation, there was nobody, no Asian American that the predominant American public wanted to be or like looked up to. Maybe before me there was like Bruce Lee and all this kung fu stuff, but even then that was kind of like a caricature, right? So now I think it's kind of interesting, right? That.
But how about when like Kim Jong Il came out?
Kim Jong Il, the president?
Yeah.
A lot of folks wanted to be Kim Jong Il.
Heck yeah! In middle school, everybody had that hairstyle. You ever seen that?
The faux hairstyle. Anyways, speaking of Filipinos, 2008, major year for music, I think, for APIs, especially in hip-hop. You know, just for the fact that, like, you know, a lot of second generation, third generation folks are growing up, mm-hmm. growing up under the hip-hop music as a pop music now, right?
Yeah.
I think there's been a lot of groups that came out this year, a lot of APIs, not just Filipinos, but Asian Americans putting out music. But a veteran in the scene, Bamboo, Filipino American from LA, just dropped his latest album, Exact Change.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So let's segue into a song from there. You know,
let's do that. Good transition.
Critical 2008 album. This album is called Exact Change, and this song is called Crooks and Rooks.
Yo. Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes, raw denim Levi's, hanging off my thighs, gas prices on high, so I'm coasting in the ride, money in my socks, freedom on my mind, easy on the gas pedal, minivan professional, undercover cop, follow close in a rental, heavy metal, single action, 3 pounds, nickel plate put away, since the day I saw my newborn's face, now I think 3 times before I bought that fist, I mean, homie, I teach peace in the hood to the kids, so how it look if I get took to prison on some dumb ish? I am young and brown, they just waiting for that slip. My son live in the shadow of a schoolyard flunk, and I pray my little one don't ever see a tool dump. I do most of my reflection in the rearview mirror, but I'm blind when I wear a
Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes. Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes. Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes. Cut your head to the side.
The new era is the mind of a crook who turned everything around when his cousin got took. That's why I look through the crooks and rooks hat like I do, cause the world look different from the car rear view. Filipino from the flats, we've seen the casualties of war, so I stand behind my mic and tell my young no more. I swore I would do my best to bring that peace by uniting our gangs, no matter what street. STS, Hellside, PRDRG, Temple Street, AP, JFX, B&G, every gang from LA to all the Southeast Asia, my Cambodian, Samoan, and Chamorro gangsters. Our people are the same, it's the map that divides us. Fuck it, let me chill, just give me love when I ride up. That's me in a castle hat, crook t-shirt. I stay pushing forward, never moving in reverse. In my
castles, new era, slung over my eyes. Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes. Crooks and castles, new era, slung over my eyes.
Let's ride.
Cut your head to the side.
Yeah. bombshells on the floor, the writing's on the wall. Blitz in the store says I'm hunting for you all. Still full of dope, I'm harvesting my hope. Shipping our speedboats so we're not broke. Coca-Cola floats, the stock market broke. Somewhere in Angola, we're still craving for a go. Send me a post, yeah, send me something you wrote. School of the hard knocks, we don't like to vote.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, yeah,
Apex
yeah.
Express 94.1 KPFA Berkeley. We just heard. Well, first of all, I apologize if there was any offensive language in there. And I apologize to the listening community. That was MIA. Mm-hmm. The song's called Shells. That was a slow version. Mm-hmm. Before that, you heard Bamboo, Crooks and Rooks off the new album Exact Change. You can buy that. We can find out more how to purchase that album at www.bamboo.la. Bamboo is spelled B-A-M-B-U. Please support amazing Filipino American MC musician.
Yeah, yeah.
From LA.
Yeah. I saw MIA twice this year. I mean, last year.
You saw MIA twice in 2008?
I saw her twice. Saw her at Coachella. And then I saw her in San Francisco. Put on a good show that Maya.
Maya?
That's her name.
Oh, Maya.
Yeah.
You know, she...
You gotta catch on,
I feel like MIA... she's always been big, I feel like, amongst, like, the indie music scene.
Mm-hmm.
Like, right when she came out. But, like, this has been her year, even though she has not dropped the album this year. Paper Planes blew up over mainstream radio. In L.A., they play it on the main hip-hop station, 106. Mm-hmm. Or not one of the main hip-hop stations.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazy. It's funny though, because they bleep out the gunshots.
Yeah.
even though it's, you know,
gotta love the radio, huh?
Yeah, you know. Another big year for MIA is she is predominantly featured on the soundtrack of Slumdog Millionaire.
Yeah. Yes.
New feature film. Jason, wanna talk more about the movie?
I just took my mom on a movie date today to watch that movie.
Nice.
Yeah, it was cool. Like, I really liked it. I see, like, where a lot of people have, like, problems.
Well, what's the movie for folks who don't know?
You know, it's, I don't want to give too much away, but it's kind of basically, you know, it's a love story set to the background of a guy who's playing, who wants to be a millionaire, who comes from the slums of Mumbai.
Mumbai.
Yeah, and, there's just a lot about his life and the trials and tribulations that he has endured.
Right, right.
Yeah.
It's an interesting concept because a lot of the movie revolves around how to be a millionaire.
Mm.
Right, he's a contestant on the show and he's a slum dog. He's straight from the slums of Mumbai.
Mm.
But
it takes him to goes through every question and why he knows.
Right, every question answered right in the show, right?
Mm-hmm. See, I haven't seen it yet. I've been meaning to.
Yeah.
Chinaka, if you're out there, we're supposed to go see this.
It's interesting because it's so many levels of co-opting kind of a non-Indian phenomenon. Like, How to Be a Millionaire is a U.S. thing that got big. Yeah. They're copying that. And well, they had that copy show that the movie's based around. But also, another thing that I thought was interesting about the movie, which a lot of folks are impressed with it because of its depiction of poverty in the slums in Mumbai, except it's directed by Danny Boyle.
Thing is, it's directed by Danny Boyle, but there is an Indian co-director.
Right, and it was written, but it was also written by another, I think, English.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Caucasian.
So, yeah, and you know, I mean, the process between I think script and to actually directing it, you know, changes over the course. I think that, you know, bringing on, I think, you know, I think probably a lot of the authenticity of the depiction of Mumbai is probably from the Indian director.
Right.
So I mean, like, yeah, it kind of reminded me, like, you know, kind of reminded me, like, City of God. It had that kind of, you know, kind of
third world-esque, huh?
No. No, man, I'm talking about the the movement through the city, you know, just this kind of like kinetic energy that you find, like, you know, that they, you know, happens to. So, yeah, I hope that made sense. I don't know if that made sense.
I thought it was really entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely the editing and everything is very like City of God.
Yeah.
But I think it's also dangerous to compare it with that movie in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
But I don't conflict it. I feel it loses. I was disappointed in. Let's just say that.
Yeah. I mean, it's one of those kind of, you know, kind of Hollywood, like, kind of like movie romance type of things, and it's just like, you know, we were talking about earlier how, like, you know, every time there's these implausible romances in movies, you think about, like, 2 years after that, where, like, you know, they've been living together a while and realize maybe they didn't know that much about each other to begin with.
right. Well, you know, I think it's dope that M.I.A. is all over the soundtrack.
Yeah.
There's a remix of Paper Planes
uh-huh.
that's pretty tight. It's kind of acoustic. It has a different flip on it. I like it. Y'all should check it out. They have the soundtrack available.
It's used right. You know what I mean?
It
helps to tell the story.
Yes.
You know.
Yes. The scene that they have the song on is amazing. Actually, that's probably one of my favorite scenes in the movie. Yeah. And those two child actors are probably my favorite part of the movie. Anyways, go watch the movie Slumdog Millionaire. It's a great movie. And, you know, call us in, email us, apex@kpfa.org. Tell us what y'all thought. Another thing, M.I.A., I feel like it's her year because they remixed her song, Paper Planes, for, what's that the song called? It's on T.I.'s album.
The Swagger song.
Oh, you're Swagger like Us.
Should we play some of that?
Some of that Swagger right now.
Should we play some Swagger Like Us?
Do you have the radio edit though, Fatty?
I think I have the radio. Hold on, we're doing everything off the laptop. And I do have it. It's clean right here.
Let's do it then.
So this is Swagger Like Us. It's a song off T.I.'s new album Paper Trail, and it has a sample of Paper Planes, which I must say is a song of the year, even though it came out in 2007. I consider Paper Planes a song.
But she wrote it in 1996.
She wrote it in 1996.
No, I just said that. But see how you can believe me just because I said it on the radio, though? Let that be a lesson, Patrick. Play the song.
I'm just going to look at you blankly.
Play the song.
No one on the corner has swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us.
Hey!
No one on the corner has swagger like us.
Come on!
Swagger like us.
Come on!
Swagger like us.
Ha.
Come on!
Young Money, Grand Hustle.
No one on the corner has swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us. No one on the corner has swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us. No one on the corner has swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us. Swagger like us.
Mr. West is in the building, swagger on 100,000 trillion. Ayo, I know I got it first, I'm Christopher Columbus, y'all just the pilgrims. Thanksgiving, do we even got a Christian? Hermes pastel, I pass the dressing. My attitude is tattooed, that means it's permanent, so I guess we should.
swagger is Mick Jagger. Every time I breathe on the track, I asthma attack it. Why he so mad for? Why he gotta have it? Cause I play my whole life. Now I'm the master. Nah, nah, nah. How I feel to wake up and be the in a urine. Nah, nah, nah. Tryna get that Kobe number. One over Jordan. Can't wear skinny jeans cause my knots don't fit. No one in the corner got a pocket like this. So I rock jeans cause my knots so big. You can learn how to dress just by checking my fresh. Checking my fresh, checking my fresh. Follow my steps, it's the road to success with it. No, get better when the girls say yes. But I can't teach you my swag. You can pay for school, but you can't buy class. School of hard knocks, I'm a grad. And that all blue Yankee is my graduation cap. It's over. Dipping Rovers, whipping with the soda. Over. Did you even have any doubt after doubt it was over?
Sharper than a swagger, dagger, all metal. And my jewels, blue and yellow. The type that make them call you Carmelo. Rules as follows, stay true to the ghetto. Write your name on the bullet, make you feel special. Ha! What the f*** you boys talking about? I know it's us cause we the only thing to talk about. And I'm gone. You can go see Weezy for the wordplay, Jeezy for the birdplay, Kanye's in for diversity, and me for controversy. I'm a versus picture perfect on this paper, serve a purpose. She ain't living what you're kicking in your work. Looking from the surface, it may seem like I got reason to be nervous. Then observe my work and see that my adversity was worse. Versus autobiographical, absolutely classical. Last thing I'm worried about is what another rapper do. Ain't nobody hot as me, even if they rap their ass off, blast off and have outstanding quality. Sell a lot of records, I respect it and salute that. But spin real life on hot beats, I'm the true fan. You kick it like me, no exaggeration necessary. Living revolutionary, nothing less than legendary. Gangsta, hereditary, got it from my dad. Blow colder than February with extraordinary swag.
Okay.
That's right. Okay.
That was Swagger Like Us, sampling MIA's Paper Planes off of T.I.'s Paper Trail.
Yeah. That's kind of a stretch for an Asian American music show, but you know, I admit that, but you know, it's a great beat though. You have to admit that.
It is. Her voice was the most.
One thing I learned is not to mistake silence for acceptance. Not to think because people aren't doing anything at any particular time that they're not capable of doing something an hour from now.
Yeah.
like this. My rhyme is like the blinding fury of a billion. I'm sick of their repression, playing the sickest ways to take the country under. It's like the anger of the Tainos when the Spaniards came, raped and pillaged every high hope, putting blacks in chains. Like the sergeant in the military, watching all his comrades die, cause Congress lied and now his conscience fries. Written for the whites that invented the term white, for everyone responsible for Elie Wiesel's night, for the Nazis and for Ariel Sharon. I called upon my president and heard a dial tone. I'm on the microphone but never did hold Glocks. I just want you all to know about Pol Pot, the coldness I know not how or why it happens, but I know my rhymes are rapping, get your brain and mind unraveling, sending messages clearly when I ricochet rhymes. Happy as a McCullough, you know, say die. To the wicked and the rest of the earth, until the breathless in the dirt, kill the rays off in the face, it speaks and live forever. I want to gaze the endless ways to keep my very stretch.
Let this message be my word, a real life is my destiny from birth. We go get what we deserve, we some young scholars still finding our way. Yeah, we write just to brighten our day, take a journey.
What I paint is a bruise, an old wound like Cambodians thinking back to Khmer Rouge, just like Idi Amin, died of being a mean father to the ones he called his children, killing his greed, slaughtered Ugandan sons and daughters. And Rwanda knows the horror that I speak of, cause the soul is what's in store for us tomorrow. Bombs over Baghdad, no one's listening. Colony of past mad hopes diminishing, solemn over fat tracks, flows exquisite sense, blowing the joy that stacks of smoke in prisons. And I look at other people with the false and the lying, lying like looking at the OCOs, assaulting Jamari Kumis and Sambis, did this for Jet. A cool breeze for his release trip, hand on the page. Hey, 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 hey.
Let this message be my word, a real life is my destiny from birth. I'ma get what I deserve, we some real scholars still finding our way. And we write just to brighten our day, take a journey.
Let
with
this message be dispersed to the wicked and the rest of the earth, until the breathless in the dirt, till the rays off in a pace that speaks in the forever. I will engage the endless ways to seek my very treasure.
Hey, I walk down city streets soaked in blood. Close up, I see the whole blood, dope and drugs. Old bum sipping slowly, trying to coast his blood. Crackheads living only for the smoke and the rush. They hope for the touch, a feeling that has long surpassed them. The first taste really had a strong reaction. A life down the drain, all gone. What happened? I had been. DJ put the song on backspin. The beat keeps playing, no one saw what happened. Just ask them. But I've been singing songs of passion since I came out. Crying, screaming out my mom's stomach. And every struggle I've ever had, I'm drawn from it. That's why I still think peaceful when the bombs plummet. Cause life's a real rough mountain with a calm summit. I burp chains like a fanny Shakur. I'm bucking shots out of Tanny and George, and ain't even war.
Let this message be dispersed to the wicked and the rest of the earth, until the breathless in the dirt, kill the rays off in the face, it speaks and live forever. I will engage the endless ways to seek my very stretch.
Let this message be my word, a real life is my destiny from birth. We go get what we deserve, we some young scholars still finding our way. Yeah, we write just to brighten our day, take a journey with us.
Yes, 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 yes. That was
this is what happened.
Mr. Senbei, the homie Colin. His new is it's actually yeah, Senbei.
Senbei off of the Literary Canon.
The Literary Canon
LP,
which came out
dropped this year,
2008. Not this year.
Well, man, whatever.
You, come on, man.
I'm still going on the lunar calendar, so you know, don't even try and step.
I mean, that would be once again.
Gregorian time frame, son.
That was Senbei, Hapa, Japanese American, Irish.
Yes, and we've had him on the show.
Yes,
he's Scottish actually.
Scottish. Oh, oh my God.
So I didn't mean yes. That was Patrick nodding
sorry,
at me
Colin.
Until I said
I'm
yes.
So sorry,
Scottish,
Japanese American.
You're not all the same. Patrick thinks that.
Amazing, amazing, amazing MC, amazing person. Colin, I love you. I just want to say in 2009 that I love you. You're a brother. You're an amazing person. And watch out more music from him and his group, Broken Halos. Literary Canon, check it out. Senbei.
Yes.
2008. Jason.
What?
We saw a performance from them recently, right?
2008?
Yeah, from Broken Halos.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Volume Control.
Yeah, yeah. That was a good show.
I mean, it's good to talk about that. I mean, that's something that's coming up in 2009. Volume Control was an event that we did earlier to raise funds for the 2009 Asian Pacific Islander Poetry Summit. Poetry and Spoken Word Summit, right?
Mhm.
Tell us a little bit more about what's going to happen this year.
Well, yeah, this summer we'll be throwing up the fifth or fourth one. That's Seattle, Chicago, Boston. Fifth Asian American, Asian Pacific Islander Spoken Word Summit in Berkeley. Yeah, yes. And, you know, we have, it's open to Asian American and Pacific Islander artists from all over to come on through. And, you know, we convene, get together, do workshops, and we have a lot of great stuff planned for this year. And it's just a way for us to be able to connect with each other and, you know, on as artists and people. And, you know, last 2007 was in New York, and before that it was in Boston, before that was Chicago, and then started all in Seattle
in 2001. Yeah,
and I've been to pretty much all of them except Boston, and it's just a great experience, and probably one of the best experiences I've ever. Yeah,
the summit's a great place to kind of get into the network of the national APIA artists. It's actually, you know, like a lot of great artists have been through it, you know, like from Israel Park to Bosea, Proletariat Bronze, Eighth Wonder, I Was Born With Two Tongues, you know, Blue Scholars, Native Guns, like Illiteracy, you know, like anybody that has come in contact with this circle, you know, it's a great opportunity for you to just kind of, you know, get up close and personal with a lot of the artists that are making a lot of headway in the APIA, not only spoken word scene, but also the music scene, the theater scene, dance, visual arts, everything. So, you know, if you're in the Bay, definitely look out for it, APIASummit.com.
And it's a national summit, so it's not just for Bay folks. There will be, I mean, every year folks fly to all these places. This is a big deal. Yeah. I've never been to one, but I always hear about it, and I always feel like I've missed out on a critical, important moment for the Asian American arts community.
Yeah,
I'm not even trying to be sarcastic. It's a big thing.
No, it is. It's you know, I mean, every time, you know, it's just been going and going. The great thing is that it's continued, you know, from the first one, it's continued to keep going, and it's going to continue to keep going. You know, because they put up every, you know, 2 years, and, you know, it'd be great, like, when I'm 60 or something, that, you know, folks are still doing it.
API Summit in Mars.
Yeah, Mars.
So someone, as someone who's been to the very first one, when was that,
2001,
which is a crazy year. How important has it been for the national Asian American Pacific Islander arts community? And how has it changed you, too, as an artist?
It's important because I think it was like, you know, nothing like that as far as, like, you know, with I think, had been done on that scale before, you know. And I just remember, I didn't know what to expect when I was going there. I actually didn't want to do this anymore before I started going there.
In 01?
Yeah, in 01. I wanted to stop doing all that stuff and doing all the spoken word stuff and everything. And I was kind of like, I didn't think it was the right thing for me. And when I went there, it changed everything for me. You know, because I actually started feeling like, I actually started seeing what folks from, you know, other Asian American Pacific Island folks from across the country were doing, you know, and how their stories, you know, were similar to my stories, you know, and it is just an amazing thing to experience, amazing thing to, you know, listen to and to be a part of and to experience.
You know? Yeah. Do you remember any of the poems you did in 2001?
Oh my God. man, if anyone asks me to think about my poems from that time, I automatically curl into a ball.
I mean, let's do this. You're here. Let's hear some stuff from you. You know, I mean, there's a reason why you're here.
All right, you cool if I do a sonnet?
Do a sonnet?
Yeah, I'll do my sonnet. Is that?
Do your sonnet. Right, do my sonnet. I don't even know what a sonnet is. I'm a
okay. DJ. There's different kinds. This is like Shakespearean sonnet. So this is my Shakespearean sonnet for E40.
Nice.
Ooh. Thou language purist whose ears sever at the cleaver's tongue buried in the mouths of men of color, a phrase though must turn. How else does one see God in this language when it is a mirror that never looks back? There are words that deserve to be murdered by apostrophes. Words that must be slacked by slumped tongues. Consonants ripped from its cased housing. The audacity upgrade your baller status to politician. Not enough to feel, you got to smell me. The skein of language cannot be governed. It begs to not be impeded upon. Its neck slung to an 808 bass drum.
Nice.
Hotness.
Is that a new piece?
That one's, yeah.
So new. this is the premiere, January 1st, 2009. Of the E40 Sonnet by Jason.
Sonnet to E40.
Yeah,
I did it once before. But that was in a... This is the premiere.
Once again, y'all, 2009 summer. Do y'all know the exact date for the summit?
Yes, it is. Let's see. Hold on a second.
You got 45 seconds to explain.
Yeah. My bad. It starts July 30th and goes to August 2nd.
Nice. Yeah. Okay. That's going to be in Berkeley, UC Berkeley, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, which would...
For more information, go to apiasummit.com for more information about how you can be a part of it. Coming up next...
Speaking of premieres, this is the new Blue Scholars track known as Coffee and Snow.
Which was made...
The video just premiered.
It just premiered, and it was made because they were snowed in, and a lot of shows got canceled. Yeah. Seattle, Blue Scholars, Geologic, was up.
It's cold. Yup. First I came home, and next thing you know, a plan get a slow, cancel the show, now I'm chillin', can't let go, I gotta catch that feeling. Hands to the ceiling, but I know I can't be holed up in this spot for long, with a beat this hot and not drop the song, with pajama pants on, the chance to make what an old school head calls a classic take, track 8 to the new Jackson, that's the breaks, I hate fakes with a passion, can't get enough of everlasting, basement assassin, chasing a dragon. Not cause I'm Asian, more cause we need more fire to warm these nuts, keep them toasted, cold out of the hood, with mind over matter, but the matter came first, Brown show you how the thing works, taking in the church like King, but we're seeing his dreams in reverse, say we need more self-esteem, I say we need free first, water for that deep sea thirst, hotter than a Philippine street, I'll make the heat worse, calling out the sun, won't see a penny of that bailout fund, so I gotta keep it current or I'm laid out, done, building up a fort just in case out front, screen fades out, credits finna start, throw that now with the Lenin and the Marx, veterans of wars waged in our backyards now, no surprise, kids is connoisseurs, wow. And I came from an owl, never seen a blizzard, so the weather stayed foul. But it grew on as I got grown. Blue Scholars got started, I was sleeping on futons at home. Can't complain when my people starving. That's the reason that I don't rock no crystalline carbon. And my folks keep falling, and our snow keeps falling. And 09 keep marching sincerely. G.O. and Sazi, gotta get that coffee. Follow me. Let's go.
Hello? shit Wednesday, yo. You blow a kiss back, and time stops.
Yeah, that was Little Dragon. What track was that, Fatty? That was off the new remix EP.
It's called the Wink Remix featuring Sanja.
Yes, yes, yes. They came out and played at Cafe du Nord a couple of weeks ago. Heard it was hot. I was kind of mad. I was in New York. And then when I got to Cali, they went to New York. So I have yet to see Yukimi.
Yukimi?
Yes.
The lead singer?
Yes.
Japanese?
Yes.
No, I'm sorry. Adriel's mic keeps like kind of tripping out.
Okay.
There you go. There you go. It's like the new year kind of kinks. What's the Jason?
Huh?
We got Jason Bayani in the house, y'all. Proletariat Bronze. Yeah. My name is DJ Fatrick. Adriel Lewis. This is Apex Express. It's actually the Pretty Buoyant Show on Apex Express.
Yes.
Which is first Thursdays in the month.
Yes.
Kind of youth culture, pop culture, API, hip hop, all that fun stuff that that we try to twist into a public affairs show.
Exactly, exactly.
Adriel.
Yes.
He's fresh off a crazy tour with his group Illiteracy.
Kind of fresh. I came back about 2.5 months ago.
I mean, that's fresh, man. I mean, that's a fraction of 12 months.
Yes,
so it's
true.
Pretty fresh.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Anything like, that's not from 2007 is still fresh.
Exactly. Yeah. So, what do you look forward to in 2009?
2009. You know, I think 2009 is gonna be, I say it's gonna be the year of the come up. I think anybody who doesn't sleep on 2009 is gonna reap multiple rewards, because I think a lot of people are kind of prepping for 2010, so beginning of a new decade, right? And so I think 2009 is gonna be kind of slept on, but you know, I'm telling you. The getting is good right now, you know, so go get yours. Let me get mine in 09.
Jason Bayani.
Well, what am I looking forward to in 2009?
What are you looking forward to in 2009?
You know, getting through all this mess. You know what I mean? Having, a better, I'm looking forward to a better future. Then, I mean, like, as much as cool things happen, I mean, there's a lot of heaviness in the air right now, you know?
Right.
You just feel it the way, you know, way people are, way it just feels, you know? It's just like, my whole body be tense some days and stuff, but I'm looking forward to a lot of that clearing up. You know, I'm looking forward to something, but, you know, a lot better.
Right on. And what I look forward to, I don't know, I'm still getting used to. Nobody cares. Nobody asks me. I'm not even going to say it.
Hey, Fatty. Huh. Hey, Fatty, what do you look forward to in the year 2009 AD?
I don't know. You know, I'm looking forward to that new PBS album. You know, there's a new group coming out. I think that's going to be dope. We're going to end the show with a preview track from them. I just, you know, 2008 was really good, I feel, for... I mean, in terms of what we cover on the show, like API Pop Culture, it was a great year. You know, you have... all the stuff that we went over. Bamboo's album came out. Hopi Spits Hard, who we're about to spin next, her album came out. Dope Panay, MC from the Bay. Just more music, you know, more music, more exposure, that kind of thing. DJing more. Oh, I think I see Dennis Kim in the.
Dennis and Kane was supposed to come through. He showed up at 7:55, like 4 minutes before the show's about to end.
All right, so we're gonna end it out with two tracks, two folks that you should look out for in 2009.
Yes,
the first one's Hopi Spits Hard. The track is called Trunk off her Diamond Dame album, which struck earlier in 2008. But
yes,
she's got a lot of new stuff coming out. Amazing, amazing MC. Check it out. And then we're gonna close it out with Schizophrenic Love by the Pretty Boy Society.
Yeah, how about those guys?
It's gonna be dope. It's gonna be dope. Thank you guys. 94.1 KPFA Berkeley, Apex Express.
Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Where the speakers knock. Up and down the block. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Where the speakers knock. Up and down the block. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. The speakers knock up and down the block.
With a microphone, let me clear my throat. Hope never joke and throw a metaphor than your jugular. Hope you simply ripping lyrics like Kong Division. My song give you vision. Listen, I'm a Queen Kong. I'm Buck Gun. You can't see me off on worst days. Take accumulating in 08, my birthday. Word plays now, fighting words. We're in battle mode. Everybody's drunk, rattle hope. Yours is back at home. Exactly. My ladies got rap by the pack. Next, push and slap. Sending training back to the factory. Atmosphere suddenly got a little bit too competitive. Got your slurring sentences sounding like you just said it. Get your medicine, baby, it's gonna be a long ride. Size competition wipes in my eyes shone bright. Diamond Dame on this mic now, make the moments right. How you holding crowds when Hopi on that ground now?
Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Where the speakers knock. Up and down the block. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk where the speakers knock. Where the speakers knock. Up and down the block.
So good, but it do, and I hope you feel it too. Girl, I please you, you know ain't no one ever done it better, or done it quite like how I done. But you don't treat me the way you did back in the beginning. No, you don't. You don't, and I try to hide, like it don't faze me, but you know it does. You got that schizophrenic love. Left to argue about it with,
but myself.